Hello, and welcome to the Character Creation and Selection module brought to you by CJR Gaming. My name is Christian Richards, and this is a rather short video because I ran into an error with the last video in that if I bring up my complex server and I go to the login server list characters character handler, one of the problems you'll notice, or maybe you won't, here I have a character list.add. Now I've updated this code. Originally, right here where it says outstream.toString, it originally said character list, causing a circular reference within the hash table to reference itself. So when it tried to send the operation response and serialize the parameters to send this piece, it ran into a lovely Stack Overflow error and bombed out. And it took me a couple hours of debugging. Well, an hour, hour and a half of debugging in order to figure out what had happened. But once you change that character list within the add to the outstream.toString, that'll clear up the that error. The second thing I did was I went in and I created a new client parameter code called character list. Now, the reason I did that is because inside of the code where we handle the client, not the handling of the client login requests, but if I bring up the code for handle login response, you'll see that down in here, one of the things we do is we yank out that character ID parameter from any of our messages so that the character ID never gets sent back to the client. Well, that's a problem in that I can't use that anymore. So I went ahead and created another point to go to use the character list from the client parameter code instead of using the character ID field. Once you do that, I will also go ahead and show you my database structure. If I go over to the structure, you'll see that I have created an ID and a user ID as bigint20s so that it matches up with the user. I've got a name, a class, a level, and a sex that gets put in there as well. Just for the purposes of this, I did an insert and just inserted a new character, matching it up between my test at test.com character, giving it a name, a class, a level, and then the sex of just male. Once you're running in Unity and you actually get it running, you'll actually see an operation error 0 from operation 2 because we aren't expecting anything back. In the next video, we will create the handler for getting those that list of characters and plugging them into the character list on the character select screen. Till then.